Hey y'all, I'm Kenya and welcome to my channel. I'm super grateful and so thankful that you will be joining in to plan with me today. So you guys, this video is super exciting for your girl because I get to collab with one of my homegirls. And literally, I mean one of my homegirls. I will be collabing with Miss Toya herself from the Classy Sassy Life here on YouTube, as well as my Classy Sassy Life on Instagram. So, me and Toya, we go way back. We are from the same hometown. We grew up together. We went to church together. Our parents are friends. Like, we are like family. And we both love our planners and our stickers. And so, we thought it would be cool to come together and do a collaboration. So, for the collab, we will be using a sticker book that we are both obsessed with at the moment. And if you know me, you guys know how I feel about my colorful leopard. And so, we will both be using this one, and the twist is we get to mix it with whatever floral stickers we want because we both like florals as well. And so what I chose is the Homebody Season sticker book, and then I also pulled some colorful boxes and some functional stickers. So if you're coming over from Toya's channel, welcome. I'm super excited that you joined in for the fun with us today. And if you're an oldie but goodie to my channel, then you already know, welcome back. And if you want to see what I do, stay tuned. Okay, you guys, so jumping right in, here are all the stickers that I've pulled so far. And my idea and direction for this spread is to create like a springy, colorful leopard type vibe on my planner page. And so I pulled the Homebody Seasons florals because I felt that the color palette went perfectly. It just complemented colorful leopard so well. So I was like, yeah, I gotta use these. And I just placed a floral down on Thursday to, you know, and like start jump me off. And then I'm going to clean it up a little bit with my jelly roll. And then I'm also going to place a floral on Monday up in that top right corner. And I'm gonna just see how I'm trying to decide how I want to lay this out, you guys. At this point, I wasn't really 100% sure like the design that I was gonna go for. I just knew the theme that I was looking at. And y'all, I'm so excited to be doing this collab with my friend Toya. I really want to know what florals she picked, because I mean, I felt like we had so many great options. So I'm excited to see her spread. Definitely excited. So I pulled these chunkier leopard print stickers, and I wanted to see if I could mix them in as well. But when I first saw it, I really kind of thought of a softer, springy, you know, kind of pattern, I guess you could say, on the spread instead of that chunkier color. But I'm gonna still see if I can mix in some of those pieces just to bring some more of the element, you know, the leopard print element to the spread. Now I pulled this box and I wanted to see if I could, you know, place now another color on top of that orange, like the red, but I felt the blue went the best in that corner. So I'm gonna lay that there, and then I'm going to put the red box on top of the blue floral, and I'm just gonna make me some little, you know, layering clusters, I guess you could say, out of these. And I feel like that looks good, y'all. It looks so spring already. Okay, so I'm happy looking at it. Okay, so now I'm going to see what else I can put like in the middle of the spread. I mean, I felt like on this side of the spread, the right side, I feel like it needed something in the middle because both of those are in the top corner, or the top and bottom corner of the left side of the spread. So I'm going to go ahead and put this orange box down the middle and see what I can layer around it. And I have this blue leaf and these red leaves, like this red floral flower. And then so I'm trying to see kind of how I want to put it. I'm just playing around with it. I'm mixing the stickers, you guys. I didn't put this on my wax paper initially because I don't know, I was just trying to, you know how I do, I get in the flow. So I'm playing around with the stickers in my head to see if I can kind of design it how I want it to look. And, you know, the beauty of using the wax paper, though, it allows me to pick up these stickers with ease. So I absolutely love that I have that flexibility and versatility in this. And I can just have fun with it. So I was going back and forth, and I really liked the combo of the two red florals together. So I felt that that looked the best. So I'm trying to see how I can lay it down. And right now I feel like that's a little too cluttered in that box. So I'm going to pick it up, and then I'm trying to, and then bam, I find the spot. I feel like that looks good. So now I want to see what else I can, you know, do before I make sure that that's permanent. But I think that that's this forever home. So we're going to go ahead and put some white out down to, you know, make it very nice and clean. Y'all know how we do. We white out behind our clear stickers over here. I just feel like that you don't have to do that, you guys, but it's just, I don't know, it pleases me, so I like to do it. And I clean up the bottom. Now, okay, so now I'm happy. And I'm going to take my slice tool on this one, and I'm going to trim around the edges, you know, just to make it super neat. And pick up that sticker. And for some reason, you guys, like, these stickers were a little bit thicker for some reason when I was cutting them. I did notice that, so I had to do a little bit extra work with my sticker surgery this time. Okay, so now I have this blue floral and this orange floral, and I felt that because it was in the middle of the page, it could use another floral around that box. And I don't know, I just wanted to make this real beautiful for some reason. Like, beautiful leopard is what I was kind of springy vibe, it's what I was feeling. And here I am again trying to see if these chunkier leopard print pieces will work. Y'all, I love these stickers, and I honestly wanted to use them because, I mean, I love them so much. Also, this long sticker, that honestly, it looked kind of good. It did to me, but I felt like it would be a little bit too much. Okay, so I just scrapped that page, and because I still wanted to look clean and give myself enough functional space to do checklists and stuff, and I felt like that would just really split my page down the middle. So I went in I pulled these colorful, like, rounded stickers, rounded boxes, and I thought that was a great option because it still gives me that color like that other long sticker that I cut up, but at the same time, it's broken up, so I can kind of just make clusters out of it. And so that's what I'm doing here. And I'm liking it. I'm going to put this one on Wednesday. And I do switch those out because these say to do on it. You have some in the book that say today, but, you know, I wanted to make sure that my words didn't match up, even though I ended up covering it up. So now I'm going to see what I can put on this one on the right side of the spread. And I decided to go with, like, this bluish color because I feel like that complemented that side better. But I'm trying to see where I want to lay it because I still have these florals that I haven't laid down, and I felt like that concept made sense. So let me play around with those first before I put that cluster together with that little rounded box. And I felt like, okay, so that looks good. So now I'm going to go ahead and, you know, clean it up a little bit. As you guys know, I'm going to put some white out behind it so, you know, it's seamless. And yeah, okay, that makes me happy. And then I'm going to clean it up with my slice tool a little bit. And you guys, I was like, why are these stickers? They're a little bit thicker for some reason. I don't know. And either that or I wasn't pressing hard, which with the slice tool, I will say, you don't have to worry about, like, really cutting your page because it's not an actual blade, but it's a precision cutter. So it does a really good job with cutting the stickers. But for some reason, these stickers, these florals, I had an issue with. So I was having to do a little bit more surgery. So, you know, pull out the tweezers, try to clean it up, pull my X-Acto knife so I can lift properly. And yeah, eventually I get it. So I feel like that looks good, y'all. So I'm pretty happy, and I'm just gonna, you know, make sure I got my edges straight. And yeah, it looks good. So no biggie there. I did slice it just a little too hard, like on the blue edge, but you can't really tell unless you're, like, looking directly at my page. Yeah, but I feel like I get it, so that makes me happy. So now I'm going to go in and figure out where I want to lay this blue box. And I feel like that corner works, but then at the same time, I'm trying to figure out if I want to cover up the words like I did on the other one. And I don't know, I'm just playing around with it. So another good tip about the wax paper, you can see through it, y'all. And so I pull a red box to make sure that it doesn't clash, and I don't want to put a red at the bottom. and it doesn't clash with that red floral, but I'm gonna go with the blue and just see what I can work out. We're gonna lay it over initially, but I don't like that. I feel like that's a little too cluttered in that spot. So, and it doesn't extend my page, because this is kind of like my main decor on this page I'm feeling at the moment, because it is in the middle. So I just decided to put it, layer it to the side and in between Friday and Saturday. Yeah. And I feel like that looks good. Enough balance to the spread. It gives me some blue. I got some green, some orange, and some red over there. So now I have some black boxes. And I just pull these. Actually, I'm out of black boxes, y'all. I got to get some more colorful boxes, but I'm completely out. So I had to slice this one up and cut the top off and make it work for me. But I'm going to put it on the right side of the page of the spread to give it some anchor. And then I take some smaller black boxes. And I'm going to put them in my other clusters here, and that I feel like that just anchored the spread with all the color going on, but it still helped the leopard print pop to me. And so now I'm gonna see if I can make my chunky pleat pieces work, but I don't really feel like they go with this softer look. And I mean, I could have done that. And maybe that's something I could do in the future with these. But I felt like this one was so, you know, just a soft leopard. Like, it's beautiful. I love it. So I find these washi strips in the Colorful Leopard sticker book. And y'all know I love it when they give us washi strips in our sticker books. So what I decided to do to add some more of that leopard print leopard like element to it, I'm going to take my black boxes and I'm going to give them a little pizzazz. And I'm going to layer them over in a vertical way. You know, just to give them a little bit of something interesting to look at when you look at the page. And so I'm just straightening this one up a little bit. And yeah, I feel like that looks good. So that makes me happy. I'm going to take this longer one. I'm going to put it over my box on Sunday. And y'all, I'm loving it. Okay, so now I'm trying to see what else I can add. You know, I feel like Friday is like empty. And first I need to clean this up. It's a little long, so I'm gonna, you know, pull some of that off and cut it down a little bit. Now that looks a little bit better. But Friday, y'all, is empty. Okay, so I have this gratitude sticker and I wanted to use it at the bottom because, you know, I could write in a gratitude list down there. But then again, I was like, well, maybe I should use one of these Hello Weekends, because in this sticker book you have plenty of those. And I was like, oh, that would be cute, and it would add some more of that colorful leopard vibe to the top. And Friday would be kind of like the spot to do it, which, you know, for this upcoming week we do have like a birthday party we'll be doing. It'll be my sister-in-law's birthday this week, so I'm excited, which is why I wanted, you know, plenty of space on Monday, because Monday is her actual birthday. But we'll be doing like a party for her this weekend, so I'm excited to do that and get to hang out with the family a bit. And then, so now I'm going to just pull that up. I'm going to go with it, y'all. And I had layered on top of it this blue leaf. And I don't know, I felt like it was a little bit too much. So I think I'm just going to, I feel like the Hello Weekend works there. But I'm going to pull that blue leaf up and just place that quote sticker down. And I felt like it looked good on top of Saturday. And I know I have like two word elements right there. So I'm going to try to clean it up a little bit. So I take my X-Acto knife. I'm going to lift it back up. And I'm going to put some white out so it's seamless under the word weekend. So that way you can, you know, see it. And okay, so now I'm going to white out that box. And I feel like that looks better. Okay, yeah, so that makes me happy. Now I'm gonna go in with my checklist and I'm just gonna add a few. I'm gonna add some to Tuesday, you know, just a few to give me some more functionality in the spread. And you guys, y'all know how I feel about checklists. Normally, when you add these into your spread, it tends to bring the spread together. Like, it does it for me. I don't know, it's been my thing here lately. So I feel like that did something. And then I'm gonna add some to Friday, because like I said, Friday was looking a little bare. But I felt like these checklists, it just fixed it. Okay, and so now I'm gonna put some in my free space. And, you know, I can make this list whatever. So that's what I love about this. I can make it whatever, you guys. So, okay. Now, I feel like that looks good. It's pleasing to the eye. So now the only other thing is I feel like I have like a quote on the right side of the page, but I don't have any wording or anything on the left side of the spread. So I'm just searching my stickers to see what I can come up with. And I found these long quote stickers, but I felt like, I don't know, I just didn't feel like it went. It didn't fit the, you know, what it was looking like. So I tried that gratitude sticker again, and I feel like that was a little bit too big, a little bit too much. So I, you know, go against that, and I'm gonna just see what else I can kind of find. And then I did find in the sticker book they have like these labels that say like the plan. So, but I felt like that one looked better in my free space, honestly, and it made more sense because I would have more room. Tuesday is date night, and I did find that sticker, but I didn't feel like it looked right. It was more of a circular sticker. So I'm trying to see if I can make it work, but I'm going to put it back and I'm going to go in with a work sticker, which Mondays I have meetings. So that'll be good for that. I have a lot of things I need to do for the office. And then I'm going to put ASAP on Thursday. Don't know really what I have to do as soon as possible, but hey, it's my planner. We're going to put it down. So now that makes me feel better. That anchors it a bit. And that's pretty much it for my spread, you guys. I hope you really enjoyed this plan with me. Please like, comment, and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. And definitely be sure to check out my girl Toya over on the Classy Sassy Life. Let her know that I sent you. And please check out her channel and see what she did and what floors she used with her colorful leopard. And until next time, love ya. Bye.